morning. Good morning from Melbourne, Australia. Good evening to friends in North America, and hello to anyone watching on replay. My name is Nancy Hetker, and I'm an independent Stampin' Up! Demonstrator in Melbourne, Australia. And today I am going to be creating a card using the Be My Valentine bundle. Actually, I guess it's here we go. It's a whole suite collection. And I am going to be using the bundle and the paper and the ribbon. And it's in our mini catalog, the January to April mini catalog. And once again, my computer thinks that my feed has stopped, but I don't think it has. Yep, there we go. Hello, Gladys. Hello, Paula. Thanks for joining me this morning. So today I am, I've put grid paper on, although I do still have my glass mat on there. I am trying to keep you from being blinded by those circles. I do love my glass mat, which you can get if you join my team or another demonstrator's team through the end of February. It is available as a bonus for signing on as a demonstrator. And let's get crafting. So I have some pieces of cardstock and designer series paper already cut, but I'm going to bring in a different piece of cardstock and my Stampin' Pierce mat, which I've also covered in some grid paper, to do some stamping on. And this is Daffodil Delight. I'm going to make one of those cute little bees. Get some Daffodil Delight ink on there. And if you know me, I like to clean my stamps right away and close up my ink pads so I don't have disasters happen. And now we need to add the bee's stripes and little stinger tail. And this gets punched out. So you can make your bee be facing any direction you want, but to cut it out with the punch, oh, I'm going to be viewing a second. Let's see, we might be able to just get it there. I'm gonna get lots of ink on here. Make nice solid, yeah, no. Gonna do another one, get it too close to the edge. Two sides to every piece of cardstock. Okay. Now, that's better. Now I'm going to punch that out, and to do that, we put it in, get it all nicely aligned. And I will set that aside. It's going to go, I want it to fly that way, so I'm going to add a face, and we have three choices. Oh, no, sorry, four choices in faces. This winky guy, this smile with the eyes closed, and this one who's doing the side eye. I don't quite know why they've got a side eye, but that's not the look I'm going for, so I like that smile. There we go. So that's the B. And now I'm going to come in again and stamp the wings. This is Petal Pink. And again, I'm going to double check my orientation. Yep, that's what I thought. And those get punched out with this heart shape. And the heart is fun, you know, just to be a heart, that's great. But it also gives you a tab to attach your wings with. So I will, what did I do with my bee? Covered them with the Petal Pink. And then we'll do some more details here. Let's do a couple of antennae. That's right, this one goes upside down even. Bring my punch back in. And then play Find the Antennas. There we go. Okay. So, there's my B. And I'm going to bring in a couple of glue dots. And build up my B. If I do one glue dot, it tends to kind of pivot on the glue dot. So I'm going to actually do two. And then it doesn't pivot. On this one though, it's so small. We are just going to do the one. Come here. So here's what I mean about the pivoting. It does a little bit, but it's going to be fine. Okay, so there's the B. What else do I need to do? Oh, sentiment. So I am using the You're as Sweet as Honey sentiment. And it was important to me to use the Stampin' Pierce mat on especially the body and the stripes. I suppose it's the thorax, the head and thorax, but the body of the bee. Because it is a solid image, the line images with the photopolymers tend to work just fine without the mat, especially on the glass mat. They stamp up really nicely. So I'm going to leave that. I'm going to trim the ends, but I'm going to wait till I see how I want it on my card. Clean that off. And then I've got one more little rectangle. Of basic white, and I'm going to stamp this bee trail in smoky slate. Just, I think, about there. There we go. If you've joined me, please do say hello. Love to know who's with me today. Okay, I think that is my stamping. I'm going to do some assembling. I'm going to start by gluing a few pieces of Designer Series paper. And if you're new to my videos, you'll notice I almost always use liquid glue for flat layers because I like that it gives me a moment to nudge things into straightness and alignment. Once you put stamp and seal down, it's down. So often when I'm doing end-to-end strips, I cut it a little bit long because I know how long this should be, but sometimes it's a little bit off and I get a nicer edge if I just come in and trim it right there. And I'm going to add these little honey jars right there as well. And I want to get about the same margin on this side as I have on this side, and then equidistant top and bottom. It's telling you what I'm looking for as I'm placing this. Okay. Now I'm going to bring in a bit of this sweet sorbet ribbon. And you can use glue dots, you can use some stamp and seal back there. My favorite thing though is the cheap and cheerful sticky tape. So that should be approximately the middle of this strip, going down over that honey jar. And there we go. And that is going to wind up on there. But first, we're going to add this bit of Designer Series paper. This has the honeycomb. And this one is going to go there. Hi, Christine. Thanks for joining me this morning. Oops, I wanted to be back this way, so. Because it has to go over that bump of ribbon. I'm just holding it for an extra bit there. There we go. I'm gonna add that with dimensionals. Let's bring in a mini. Put on there. sentiment. This is how I'm making sure I get really the same angle. And I'm going to go ahead and pop that up on dimensionals as well. And now I'm going to put this on my card base. And I'm going to pop that up as well. Stand up here to get a better look at lining it up evenly. There we go. And oh, I know, I didn't really want that right there. See, I'm using the spatula end. I can often get dimensionals off pretty well with that. I call this reality stamping because you see me do it for real. I make all the mistakes and that's how I know how to fix them. Okay, there we go. That's off of there. And then I can scrape these off the back of here and put on new ones. I don't know how I stamped for what? 10 or more years without my Take Your Pick tool. Okay, we're going to try that again. I'm going to hold it off a second. I'm putting that on. Now I'm going to make a bow out of this ribbon. Need it to be huge, but I have found that if I get it about how I want it before I do my final tightening, I get a better bow. And I was taught to use a glue dot on the back there. But again, I have found that they kind of pivot. And if I use some tear and tape, if the ribbon is wide enough, I actually get it to hold my bow in the form of the bow gets held better too. So I'm going to do that, and I'm going to put that right there, and then I can trim off. Whoops, use the ribbon scissors. Use the ribbon scissors, and most people want to trim right at the tips there, but really go further in, you'll get a cleaner cut. There we go. And I'm just double checking something here. Okay. These are the in color dots. I'm going to add which ones? And now I'm going to position this where I want it. Should stop futzing and be done. There we go. And that is my card. Now, I have cased this design, full transparency, from Donna Gray, another Stampin' Up! Demonstrator here in Australia. But I think it's really cute. It's a nice way to use up some scraps of this paper. And I have decided, you know, we don't do many Valentines here in Australia for people who aren't your main squeeze. So I have been looking for ways to use this suite for non-Valentines. And I think this is a great card to send to a friend for their birthday or just because. And I've been focusing on that with this suite because I'm not sending Valentine's to lots of friends and family just because. So I hope you like that. I hope you give this suite a try, and I will be back same time, same place next week. Have a great one. Bye.